Hi viewers, welcome back to Sinta's Tasty Food Channel. Today I came with another recipe, eggless cake without oven and made in pressure cooker. So far I haven't posted eggless cake in my channel. So with this recipe I came with icing using Russian nozzles and beautiful colors, you can see that. So if you are new to my channel and haven't subscribed so far, please subscribe the button and please share it with your friends. So let's jump into our recipe to see what are the ingredients we require and the procedure. Here I am using 7 to 8 inches pressure cooker and adding 1 cup of salt at the bottom, and I'm gonna keep the stand to maintain the distance from the bottom to avoid cake burning at the bottom. I'm just checking the height should not stop me from closing the lid. It's good. Now this is going for preheating on medium flame for about 10 minutes. I'm taking here approximately 3 tablespoons of butter and 3.5 tablespoons of oil, 1/3 cup of powdered sugar, and whisk all these three ingredients to well incorporate. Here going in 3/4 cup of condensed milk. Whisk it again for about minimum 2 minutes. We will keep this aside. Here I have taken 1 cup of room temperature milk and going in 1.5 teaspoons of vinegar and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. This is optional. If you add eggs, it is must, but here it is optional. Let's move on to our dry ingredients. Here I have taken 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour, 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Sieve them all, ensuring well combined together. Now it's time to mix all dry, wet and the milk together, but whenever you add dry ingredients, same time add milk simultaneously. Here in this stage, don't over mix the flour anytime because cake might become harder. Just make sure that there is no lump in it, that's all. Add little flour and little milk at a time throughout your mixing. You can see our batter is ready. Now this batter is going into our baking tin. This is 7 inches baking tin. For greasing, you can grease with butter or oil. Here I have taken butter. Lining with butter paper and pouring the batter, keeping spatula across the batter to avoid bubbles. Once you finish pouring the batter into the tin, tap it down, making sure there is no bubble in it, and finally, still if you find any bubbles, take the toothpick and try to break it. Now bake the cake on medium flame for about 45 to 50 minutes, but you check with your cake. When your toothpick comes out clean, then it is done. For me, it took about 50 minutes, so let's insert our skewer and see. Yeah, it came out clean, then it is done. Let's flip our cake and take out the butter paper and see how it turned out. Look at the color of the cake, how it evenly cooked through, and see how soft it is. Can you see that? Let's start our icing on the cake. For that we need to do little prep work. I cut top of the cake, divide the cake into two layers. To get even layers of the cake, we measured it, make a mark in the center with the use of toothpicks. Insert 4 toothpicks all around the cake. Based on those toothpicks, use the thread to cut even slices. Take out all the crumbs for easy icing. Here I've taken 425 grams of mixed fruit tin. I'm gonna drain this water and gonna mix it in sugar syrup, which keeps the cake moisture. Here I'm hydrating the cake with the sugar syrup which I already prepared, and followed by a layer of desiccated coconut. This is totally optional, but it really enhances the flavor. To make the desiccated coconut powder softer, adding sugar syrup on top of that. Now it's time to add icing on the cake and level it using palette knife. Here I'm adding mixed fruit, but you can add your desired fruit. Keep the top layer and hydrate it with the sugar syrup. Now put a whipped cream all around the cake and on the top. Before proceeding to the next step, we should keep this cake in the freezer for minimum half an hour to set the whipped cream. I'm going to use weaved 60 numbered Indian made nozzle for weaving. Follow me as along going with my cake decoration. Now I'm gonna make rose flower. This is a rose petal nozzle, and always keep narrow edge upwards for making petals. I'm using here Russian nozzle. First time I'm using these Russian nozzles. Each and every time wipe out the nozzle after making the flower. I should have kept my camera on top to get the top view so that you could see the variations in the flowers. Next time I will do that. Fill the gaps using the different nozzles. It will give a nice look. Flowers without leaves can't be possible. So this is our final touch with green leaves. Guys, encourage me by showing your subscribe and your valuable comments. Those are very important for me to do another new recipe. So please share with your friends and family members. Let me cut and show you. Look at that. You can see it is clearly visible, the layers. If you like my cake, please hit the subscribe button and share with others, and hit the bell icon so that you will get the notifications for another beautiful recipe. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.